SOMED, Cervical Cancer Prevention Awareness and Health Matters. Your partner in Health Matters. Dedicated to promoting awareness of both male and female issues.
Hello everyone, my name is Edna Dapa and welcome to my channel. Today I will continue the discussion about causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding as we get acquainted with other conditions that are equally needing medical attention. My objective for creating this series is to bring wider understanding to abnormal vaginal bleeding, a condition that is experienced by most women. Being aware of the potentials that could be responsible for the disorder will alleviate unnecessary anxiety. Various reasons that are easily resolved could be responsible for abnormal vaginal bleeding. Today, I will be speaking about three processes that may cause abnormal vaginal bleeding. They are the sexual activity, sexually transmitted infection, STI, and polycystic ovary syndrome, PCOS. Sexual activity could cause vaginal bleeding or post-coital bleeding in various ways. Even though some of the causes of bleeding during or after sex may not pose a serious threat, bleeding after sex could also be a sign of health condition. Vaginal dryness due to lack of lubrication during sexual activity could cause friction resulting to breakthrough bleeding. Reduced vaginal secretion is observed in some menopausal women when the level of estrogen decreases and may lead to vaginal dryness. Vigorous sex could result in cuts, abrasions or tear on the vagina, especially in situations when vaginal dryness is experienced, thereby resulting in post-coital bleeding. The use of some water-soluble lubricants or hormonal treatments could ease this problem. Trauma, such as penetrating injury to the vagina or cervix, and sexual abuse can result in vaginal bleeding. Another condition that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding is sexually transmitted infection, STI. Vaginal infection could be because of sexually and non-sexually infectious agents. These are bacterial, fungal, and even parasitical agents that cause several vaginal symptoms, including vaginal bleeding. Infectious agents will almost always lead to a condition called vaginitis, that is the irritation or inflammation of the vagina. Characteristics of vaginitis may include redness, soreness, itching, and burning, and in some cases, vaginal discharge and vaginal bleeding. Vaginal yeast infection could be caused by an overgrowth of fungus, such as candida, that could leave the vaginal area very dry and irritated. Bacterial vaginosis occurs because of an overgrowth of harmful bacteria and could also lead to vaginitis. Gonorrhea and trichomonas are sexually transmitted diseases that could cause vaginal bleeding. Chlamydia is sexually transmitted bacterial infection that, when left untreated, could lead to many serious complications, including vaginal bleeding. Chlamydia is a disease that can cause inflammation of the vagina, and infected women may experience bleeding between periods or after vaginal intercourse. The origin of infection-related bleeding is the vagina, as most causes of vaginal bleeding are the result of direct contact with the affected area. Therefore, vaginal bleeding is so common during and after sexual intercourse. Another condition that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding is polycystic ovary syndrome, PCOS. This disease is a complex hormonal disorder where there is incomplete maturation of multiple follicles, resulting in cyst formation in women of reproductive age. The ovaries are part of the reproductive system that store and release eggs monthly. Before an egg is released, it develops in a follicle. More than one follicle usually develops, but only one frequently becomes a fully matured egg. In polycystic ovary syndrome, about 12 or more follicles start to grow, but none develop into a matured egg that could be fertilized. The ovaries of women with polycystic ovary syndrome may contain numerous immature follicles, resulting in cyst formation. PCOS is characterized by enlarged ovary containing multiple small follicles and overproduction of androgen, testosterone, and menstrual abnormalities. Excess secretion of androgen, a male hormone in the body, may cause physical signs such as excess facial or body hair. Women with PCOS experience irregular uterine bleeding due to impaired ovulation and subsequent deficiency of progesterone secretion that normally follows ovulation. These women could have excess total and abdominal fat and resistance to insulin. Consequently, PCOS could adversely ruin a woman's health by increasing the risk of diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and infertility. Many women discover they have PCOS when they are trying to get pregnant and are unsuccessful. The exact cause of PCOS is not known, but some factors that may play a role include heredity element. Certain genes might be linked to PCOS since the condition may run in families. The specific genes associated with the conditions have not yet been identified. Insulin resistance is observed in PCOS condition when the body, rather than taking up the hormone to control the amount of sugar in the blood, the cells are opposed to the effects of insulin. As a result, the blood sugar level rises and the body could produce more insulin to compensate. But unfortunately, the outcome is excess insulin in the body. Increased level of insulin in the body causes the ovaries to produce excess androgen and testosterone. These hormones interfere with the development of the follicles and further prevent normal ovulation. Many women with PCOS are found to have an imbalance in certain hormones. Excess hormones such as androgen, estrogen, luteinizing hormones stop the ovary from releasing eggs each month. Symptoms of PCOS include abnormal uterine bleeding, irregular periods as the ovaries do not regularly release eggs, difficulty in getting pregnant because of irregular or failure to ovulate, excess androgen or male hormones in the body, which may cause physical signs such as excess facial or body hair. Diagnosis of polycystic ovary syndrome can be carried out by medical history and record of menstrual periods, blood tests to measure hormone levels and to check for other conditions, an ultrasound scan to see if ovaries have PCOS. We can see that the cause of vaginal bleeding could be sexual activity, sexually transmitted disease, and dysfunctional natural process causing polycystic ovary syndrome. All these are treatable and will not result to gynecological cancer. We must observe our bodies and note any anomalies and concern. Some symptoms could flag off conditions that will salvage health emergency without delay. We must recognize when to seek for medical attention. This is the essence and purpose of this awareness creation. I hope to see you next time when I will be discussing about more causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe, like, and share this video to your friends and family, and I will see you soon.